We are live. Launching our game for the final time. Good drink. Alright. Come on. Launch faster, Steam. Alright, I may be talking more than usual, even if I don't get any mumble guests, as this will be my first stream since my girlfriend has returned home. Just got back from the airport, figured, why the fuck not, let's finish off Follow Cybertron. Done fast enough. Maybe play some Evil Genius or one of my Civ games. Just, kill some time in the evening. That's alright. Continue campaign. I guess we better fucking pick off where I left off last night. Yes, enemy jets. Here we are. A day in the life of a Decepticon soldier. Oop, time to get to work. The bell's ringing. So while you work. What's up, buddy? Hey.
On your feet! Someone's flying the shockwave's data logs!
Yes, sir.
Go check out the main server. Make sure it's still secure. I'll lock down the main entrance. What are you waiting for? Move!
No, I was the slacker all along. If I'm the slacker, then that bastard interrupted my fucking movie.
Probably another one of shockwave's tests.
Don't watch the movie. I want to finish watching my movie. Aw. Can I watch the movie here? No.
Back so soon? Or did you screw it up like you do everything else?
Oh, fuck you.
I hate these new scanning systems.
Access granted.
Alright, you do that. I'm gonna slack off more.
Our glorious leader, Megatron, has returned. All hail Megatron!
Long live Megatron!
Oh, how patriotic of us.
Shockwave isn't letting up on his tests. They've been non-stop for the past 100 megacycles.
At least we don't have to watch it.
Thought you were checking on that server!
Search every room!
But I wanted to hang out. Get some digital donuts or something. I don't know. Whatever Decepticons do.
Starscream is a bloody criminal and traitor. If you have any information regarding his current whereabouts, contact command immediately.
Nah, but Starscream, he's a joke. Nothing to worry about.
And now that we've mentioned Starscream, it must be Starscream.
Shockwave seems to like having them around.
I don't see why.
Now, do you like hanging around Shockwave?
No.
That's my point.
Funny. Now let's get this done.
I don't like him either. Oh, you get what? What? Fucking bastard teleported away. Ooh, can I use this? Can I use this? Can I use it? Can I use it? It's a thing. Yay!
Nobody's around. Time to relax.
Yay, we're napping. Alright, time to wake up.
Ah, don't be such a lazy con.
Alert. Space bridge testing will be conducted periodically. Terminals may suffer from temporary power loss.
Yes, flash terminal I haven't used yet.
Shockwave's log. Now that the Nemesis is ready for launch, Megatron can proceed with his exploration of the target planet.
It's sparking again. Let's get that fixed. Memory cores are fried. Need to find some new ones. Shine your light over here. My optics are fuzzy.
Look at Okay, buddy.
Thought I saw someone down here.
Nah, it's nothing. Server's just ahead.
Hey, you hear about Starscream?
That idiot finally got what was coming to him.
Do tell.
Shaking bones.
He was
your
my
robot.
Best friend! You would have made partner next week. Show yourself! Why are you doing this?
Because you keep talking.
Starscream, is that you?
Maybe.
I know you're here. Show yourself!
Make me.
I'm armed! Don't come any closer!
Yes, with a flashlight. How threatening.
I give up! I give up! I give up!
Oh, since you said so nicely.
I need backup in here!
Oh, no, you fucking don't.
Help! Somebody help!
You don't need any help, buddy.
I don't want to get deactivated!
No one ever does, but, what can you do? Now, if you're gonna be that pathetic.
No, please, don't hurt me!
Oh, come
please,
on, man.
Please,
show some fucking dignity.
Oh, no! Please, just go! Please!
Come on, show some dignity. Die with a backbone. Like this.
Starscream? Hey! What are you doing here?
I hear this is where all the idiots hang out.
Hey, you look angry! We were just joking around.
Uh-huh.
Hey, I'd be angry too if Megatron made a fool of me.
Mm-hmm.
Not that you're a fool, of course. I'm the fool. So, what are you gonna do?
I'm thinking about it.
Please say something.
No.
I'm sorry. There! I said it!
Why, thank you, but still no.
I feel better.
I don't.
You know, I think we're both mature enough to move past this, don't you?
Not really.
You got nothing to say? After all that?
Yes, I do.
It's just a simple misunderstanding.
No, it's not. I'm gonna fucking kill you.
Look, if you want an apology, you got it!
Yeah, and it was a half-assed one. So I cut him.
Data logs. Shockwave's latest experiment is in the central tower. I can access it through the rear maintenance shaft. Megatron will rue the day he made a fool of me. He can keep his precious army. I will build one of my own.
Lab report 1161. Experimentation continues. Effectively meshed Autobot source code with most ferocious of creatures detected on target planet. Two powerful hind legs, a heavy tail to act as a counterbalance to the longest and heaviest jaw I have seen. Splice made with Autobot soldier Grimlok. Further strength harvested by rerouting power from central intelligence processing system to legs, jaws, and arms.
Interesting.
Server isn't gonna fix it! Ah! Oh no! I need help, someone! Alert! You're hardly even worth shut down!
You fall before me so easily! I won't stand for this! each security tower.
Sounds legit. Let's do it. Stealth. Fucking restarting from checkpoint.
Back so soon? Or did... Hey! Get off me! Hit the alarm! Got a better shot from over.
Must ensure that no one survives to report me.
Thank you.
Supreme's gone mad. Stay alert.
What do you suppose he's after?
Shockwave's lab quickly.
object continues to resist every test. I suspect they were administered incorrectly.
I assure you, the tests were done as you instructed.
We shall see, Sharp John.
I was in a bit of a mood anyway.
What do you mean?
Nah, I've been arguing with the missus.
Should I speak more slowly?
Yeah, it's fine now. It was just, at the time, I was still a little miffed.
I know what Shockwave has done to
what happened?
Your team. I looked excruciating.
Stupid stuff.
I bet you're just trying at the bit to pay him back. But what is a grimlok to do?
Yeah, I just got back a little while ago from driving her to the airport, so.
And you're entirely too stupid.
Well, hope things worked out, because don't want to see that happen.
Oh yeah, things are fine.
You will swear your allegiance to me. You will do my bidding.
Her visa's done at the end of the month, and today was the day of her flight, so.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah.
This offer won't last forever.
Not last week. The week before, we actually got back from the, people doing the fiancé visa
you don't have a choice.
With some more information they needed, and supposedly they're going to be making their decision on the 16th, so with any luck I'll hear soon whether or not we'll actually be getting our fiancé visa.
Hello.
So
I'm talking to you.
Hopefully that'll be a yes. She can do her interview and stuff over
and
in England.
Speaking is a lost art, don't you think?
No, thanks.
Get everything set in motion, get her over here.
I can help you!
Right now, play my game, Joyce of DiSerrano. Maybe do something after, I don't know.
Nothing feels right. Hard to think.
Grimlok's like, yeah right, you can't help me.
Test subject is
Grimlok's like, fuck you, I'm Grimlok.
It's escaped!
Must find my team.
Call for reinforcements!
Where are my teammates?
Alert Shockwave!
Warning. region containment cell 1G, subject prone to violent outbursts. Please escort subject back to containment area.
What has Shockwave done to me?
Initiating lockdown.
Take me to my team!
There he is! Open fire!
You run! What
a throw!
Oh, did you just catch up to the execution?
Yes.
That's how he heals.
Yeah, I saw that.
Dude!
Oh, it's even better when you're in dino form. Because you fucking, like, eat things.
Yes,
that's
my
crazy.
Team.
He's an Autobot.
Actually, they do explain that. When they talk about Grimlok, in some of the audio logs and stuff, is basically Grimlok was very militaristic compared to other Autobots. And he and Optimus used to argue all the fucking time about what to do, because Grimlok was always the first one to basically say, fuck it, don't negotiate, just attack. Also, it's fun to play as a Titan class. Grimlok is the only Titan you ever get to play as. Other Titans are the same size as Grimlok.
All this security must be getting
bigger than a Titan would be a Marauder, which are the huge ass tanks from the first game that you have to attack from behind. They're back in this one, but they're only in robot vehicle form, and they take the form of artillery platforms in this game instead of tanks.
I've siphoned your cerebral circuitry.
Which is still pretty badass. Power to combat related functions. You're a robot that turns into a fucking artillery emplacement. I mean, come on.
98% of your redesign is dedicated to the total destruction of your enemy.
Lucky you.
Yeah, scouts are usually the smallest. And then above scouts are the regular size. And then it's Brute, Titan, Marauder. And then you start getting into special cases like Omega Supreme and Decepticon and shit. Combinacons, like the Combaticons and the Constructicons. Yeah, because he basically took like 98% of Grimlok's brain and reprogrammed to do nothing but provide processing power to his combat functions, like his especially in Dino form. Earlier before you came in, I picked up an audio log that said that he rerouted all the brain power to his dinosaur forms, legs, jaws, and tail. Which is why Grimlok can't talk right anymore.
Did he ever get that function back?
No. He basically got his hardware rewired. So it would take like a drastic robo surgery to fix him. Not without like completely rebuilding his robot form and his vehicle form. I don't think he could function as a Dinobot. At least not nearly as powerful if he had his brain functions fixed.
Well, those things are very big. He fully has brain power, he just can't do it.
Yeah, he has the the capacity to think properly. He just can't pronounce and enunciate properly because of all the power it takes to power the rest of them.
So, if they put him into a computer, he basically talks like any other person.
Probably. Kind of like Omega Supreme talks funny, but he's just as intelligent as anyone else.
Yeah.
The other one.
Yeah, I got it!
I'm sorry, but every time I hear Omega Supreme, I automatically think of Banjo as his little fascination with the little toy thing that he still has called Omega Supreme. And I'm just going, why do you like this guy so much?
Omega Supreme was neat in the old cartoon.
No, not Omega Supreme, it's Omega Scream.
Oh.
That's different one.
Screw it. Omega Supreme score.
Yeah, and the thing is, he has this little toy that has a little function where, like, he looks kind of like a tank, but he pushes his butt and twirls his torso around.
Yeah, Omega Supreme had one of those things like Optimus' trailer where he had a launch platform that stayed on the ground when he took off in rocket form and was always there when he landed wherever he was going. But they never explained why. But if he transforms on the ground, the platform transforms with him. So, how the fuck does it work? It's a part of him, but it stays behind. But it's a part of him that he picks back up.
Alert. Approaching dissection lab 7B.
Yeah.
If anything, here, I can just, right here, it's like, this is exactly what he's like, he's the ultimate badass. No one can be Omega Supreme.
Buzz cut good.
He's like, he has an obsession with the old G1 Action Master Elite of Omega Supreme.
What Shockwave did to us? Cracked us open?
Nah, you can't beat Buzzsaw.
No.
The color swap of Laserbeak that speaks eloquently and wants to murder everything.
Look at this one.
It actually has, I think, the record for the most Autobot kills of any Decepticon, even though he's just a Cassetticon.
Insecticons communicate on a specific frequency.
You're a tiny little laser beak thing. How do you have so many kills? Because he's fucking Buzzsaw.
The exceptions being Hard Shell, Sharp Shot, and Kickback.
In fact, if you look up his thing in the wiki, there's a wiki quote somewhere that says, you cannot kill Buzzsaw, you can only make him more pissed off at you. Because at one point he dies and he comes back as like a zombie con.
My research indicates
and kills somebody. I think he actually kills the guy who killed him.
His mind and thought processes have proven psychotic and unpredictable.
I think it's neat that they actually brought back the Insecticons for this game.
Hardshell prefers advanced combat strategy and weaponry as opposed to relying on his natural instinct. He is a most dangerous adversary.
Grimlok, this room. I was in a room like this with Slug.
Slug, where is he?
Think I remember.
They made a masterpiece, Buzzsaw.
Oh god, did they?
Yes.
They better fucking have his fucking Buzzsaw.
It came out this year.
Nice.
Yes, he did it after the Laserbeak too, but he's a masterpiece.
Yep, and he's just one of Soundwave's cassettes.
More subterranean life forms have surfaced.
I just going, oh gosh, masterpiece.
Actually, when you stop and think about it, Soundwave and his cassettes are probably the most effective Decepticons of any generation.
You got a point.
I mean, look at Prime.
Research has revealed
he almost never fights, but when he does, Soundwave's fucking beast.
Of known matter. It's kind of funny, I'm looking through all this, and it's like, Masterpiece are kind of like the perfect grain of Transformers.
By far the most
they're like the top of the line,
Yeah, if you compare to Gundam, Masterpiece is basically, the perfect grade.
Yeah.
Of Transformers. So I'm looking at all of them, it's like, they only come out with like one or two every year, and it's like, it's kind of the same thing with the... Actually, it's not the same with Gundam, because they release those like a perfect grade every.
I can't even keep track. They have so many Gundams that only exist as models. or as trading cards.
No bodies. Need a new name.
Do you know how many perfect great Gundams there are in existence completely?
Considering how long they've been making them, I couldn't even fathom a guess.
Just take a ballpark. I could easily tell you.
At least 50 to 100.
You are so over.
Oh, am I over?
Way over.
Huh. I can't use Teletran, I'll smash it. Oh, this is a good audio log.
Shockwave's log. Inspired by my enhancements on the Autobots, I have decided to create a few upgrades for my personal arsenal. When finished, this gun could generate
14.
Power to rival even Megatron's.
Only 14 perfect rays.
Really?
There's different variations, but in total, 14.
Spread across the different Gundam series, or are they mostly the 00 universe?
Across all Gundam series. So
nice. I want this gun. Give me Shockwave's gun. Give me Shockwave's gun. It's right fucking there.
Allow me to
really part of me wants them to make a third one of these.
I think everyone does test
you. Because I would love to play one of these on Earth, and considering they name drop the Constructicons offhand, if you talk to one of the decepticons when you first play as Megatron after you defeat Starscream. They'll mention that they always wanted to destroy the big statues ever since the Constructicons built them. So I would love to see the Constructicons playable as Devastator. Especially if they kept Bruticus. Could you picture that? That'd be an awesome two-way boss fight. You have to fight Devastator and Bruticus.
Grimlok, we got snipers! Guess they don't call them hard shell for nothing!
Apparently they need an Optimus Prime or Optimus Convoy.
Surprised.
We are too basic to play with a zombie prime.
I always liked the evil prime for robots in disguise.
Not so tough now, is it?
How amazing how many toys there have been.
Well, consider how many series there have been.
Or even different models.
I mean, just Gen 1 alone had a lot, and then they added more, a little bit more each consecutive version.
Yeah. In fact, I'm looking at the Henkei model of Convoy. Dude, that actually looks pretty cool.
Actually, I got a poster the other day at Newberry's. It's all a bunch of the Gen 1 Transformers. And like a cross between the toys and the anime.
Ooh, nice.
So like the picture of Ratchet is an anime version of the Ratchet toy with like the stupid like base and everything.
You
it's hilarious, but like there's some there I didn't even know were actually like in Gen 1. Like there's a fucking like B one. I'm like, wait, when did the Decepticons have a B?
Shields are coming down! Get ready! Move it, Grimlok! See? Not bad!
Approaching surgical unit in 10D.
This is the place, I'm sure of it.
I would love to see them bring back Tidal Wave as a character.
Oh, Tidal Wave, I remember him from watching Armada.
He was better in Armada than in Energon. Because in Energon, they did the stupid fusing thing. It's like, why is this giant aircraft carrier-sized thing little more than like shoulder armor for Megatron? Like, it made no sense.
You know what's kind of funny is that when I was watching X-Play's review of doing Transformers, and I was like, okay, we're doing this, like, why is this place moving? And all of a sudden, this little slides over, all battleships are Transformers, you see it, you see Tyler slowly, like, rising from the sea, you're like, oh.
Oh, my favorite is still, like, that first scene when he first shows up, and he's just, like, saying his name over and over and over again, he's, like, descends from the heavens, and all the Autobots are like, what the fuck is that?
It's like, you look at him and go...
Like, that scene from Armada is, like, one of the best scenes ever.
I just don't understand why... I mean, it's the only thing that did good in that series. And I'm looking at this going, dude, Tidal Wave could, in essence... Now, here's the question. Size-wise, would you compare to Metroplex?
Hard to say, because they didn't have Metroplex in that version, I don't think.
They didn't, but if you compared him, like, his size, to what we know when he,
Gen 1 Metroplex, I think he'd be a little smaller, but not by much. This Metroplex, could probably step on him. Or at least ride him as a surfboard. Or, well, more like a skateboard, but still.
I wish they showed a size, like, you know, how tall is he?
Well, the problem with that was, is after his first appearance, they kept changing his size. Yeah. Because I remember in some scenes he was just as big as everybody else, and others he was fucking massive. Sometimes within the same episode it would change, it was just like, what the fuck's going on here?
That was, again, that was just the animation team effing up so bad, in fact, also that... Hasbro wanted this anime so done so quickly that they didn't even finish the series. They didn't even finish most of the show.
Actually, there's, I think, like, six episodes that only Japan had of Armada, because they pushed out to America so fast that they basically just said, screw it, we're just not going to translate these episodes.
Let's see if we can find out how tall he is.
Well, having been on an aircraft carrier once, I can say it's fucking huge. Especially if you consider the vehicle form is usually smaller than the robot form.
Also, they changed his size and energon.
Yeah, because the Energon, he was smaller. At least the Energon, he was consistently smaller, but... Also, I think they changed his vehicle mode in Energon to a battleship. Yeah. Oh, I just thought that'd be awesome for the next game. If they do a third one of these, they need to bring back the triple changers. So if they do a third Cybertron game, they need to have a triple changer.
But your combat efficiency has
marginally.
Triple changers are fucking awesome.
Your failure to change forms hinders your
progress. Could Grimlok be a triple changer?
No, Grimlok's just a regular one.
The Insecticon
the only two I know of offhand are potential. Astro Train and I think Garage.
For some strange reason, when you say triple change, I'm all of a sudden thinking of Transmetal Optimus Primal.
I think he would count as a triple change. Did he have three modes?
He had a robot mode, and I think he had four.
Because the Gen 1 triple changers had two vehicle modes. Astro Train was a robot, a train, and a space shuttle. And Mirage was a jet, a tank, and a robot.
I'm looking right now. I'll sorry, just give me a second. I'm looking to see if I can find his transmetal function.
I just hope they don't bring back Headmasters and Target Masters, because that was kind of retarded.
Yeah, Okay. I'm looking. Okay, he had gorilla mode, he had a flight mode, a tank mode, and then robot mode.
Yeah, so he'd have been triple changer.
He was a quad changer, oh gosh.
No one's tougher than me!
Then he went full transmetal into what we saw before, which is like a big ultimate beast we saw on the show.
Yeah.
I think that was after somehow fuses spark with the Matrix.
We'll tear you apart.
And he's like, oh shit.
I still have a soft spot in my heart for the stupidity that was Robots in Disguise. Just because they had the evil Optimus as the head of the Combatagons instead of whoever the normal one is, Onslaught. Instead of Onslaught, they had Nemesis Prime as the Combatagon, who was a missile truck.
I just
want to
know how tall he is. That's all I want to know.
It should be on his wiki. And Munch.
I'm looking on the... There's a TF wiki, and then there's the Transformers wiki.
I forget which one I usually use for Transformers.
Is it the one that has
the
most style, or is it the one that most wikis are using nowadays?
I haven't looked in a while, so I can't say.
Was the site
moved? Did that hurt?
Fuck y'all, I'm a T-Rex.
For some strange reason, I feel like he should have a tail stop.
He doesn't, but fuck it, I have a flamethrower. Even though it's completely useless.
Time for me to take my leave!
And movie reference.
Excuse me.
There's actually a lot of the old movie references in this game.
I feel terrible.
Oh yeah, the original movie.
They love referencing the original movie in this game.
But I'll survive.
Well, why not?
Especially with the Dinobots. Like they actually at one point do the whole beryllium, bologna, silesium, salami argument.
Are you gonna stand there all day?
I like the flood. You look terrible.
Excuse me.
Where is Slot?
It's like he messed up all the Dinobots.
Last I heard, yep. Shockwave carted them off for...
Turn them all into dinosaurs.
Shockwave.
Slug!
I wanna know what they were before they were Dinobots.
Grimlok, look!
I just find they have weird names.
Watch out!
Oops, Slug. Ed.
That looks
Sludge.
Like a tower from the Sea of Rust!
It is. You were right. The Decepticons were after it the whole time. And Optimus was wrong!
And Snarl. Don't forget Snarl.
Right, Grimlok?
Oh, yes.
You'll be back. You, I'm fine.
Actually, because I have the Dinobot Insecticon and Insecticon DLC, in multiplayer mode, I can play as a Dinobot for all classes.
Grimlok, follow me!
I don't get any of the bonuses for being a Dinobot, but I do get the dinosaur alternate forms. It's mostly cosmetic. You're still just as fast and have the same attacks as a regular class for that.
This way, Grimlok.
But it's still funny. I can do the same thing with the Insecticons. Spinator.
Hi, everyone.
Big up, Spinator. Spinator sounds like a pink retard.
But done by Scott the Seal.
Still sounds like a retard.
Grimlok, I'm taking fire! Hold on! I've got an idea!
Almost anything is done by Sky.
The entire credits is just his name repeated over and over again. And then there's just one side credit. Oh yeah, Megatron was this guy.
Yes.
I can always laugh at their version of Megatron because of just ending every sentence with a yes, yes.
Yeah,
and
it's also really good. It's done by Ocean. It's done by Ocean Group. Here comes the question I want to ask. When you look at the Optimus and Megatron in both.
I've actually only ever seen the one, so I want it now. Classic Optimus and Megatron are best. That's all I have to say.
Three more Frank Wilkins.
Yep. Yeah, the only person I will accept as a substitute is Leonard Nimoy's Galvatron. Game for a minute.
How?
I don't know, but I somehow fixed it by breaking it again.
Slug, wait up! Slug! Tired of this.
seems to have a habit of putting his dinosaur arm head thingy in the bed. He is even seen brushing his teeth.
What?
Yeah. Brushing his teeth up of his own robot head, of his own animal head.
Huh. Makes sense. That actually makes sense. Because I think their animal forms were partly organic. To help shield them from the... whatever it was. Need the hammer. He's doing pretty well on his own with a sword.
Well, yeah, but it was a sword, and it's like, give me that hammer.
Plus, he kind of already is a hammer.
Grimlok! Where you been?
Shut up and fight, Swoop!
You can't beat us all, Grimlok!
Little bugs, do your worst.
Good luck.